Hi to one and all. Now we will discuss about VLSI design subjects. So far we covered up to 2.5 units. In unit 1 we discussed about fabrication process of MOS transistors, CMOS logic circuits, BiCMOS logic circuits and fabrication procedure for resistors and capacitors. In second part of first unit discussed about electrical properties of MOS transistor in terms of IDS current versus VDS and expression in three different regions: cutoff region, non-saturation region and saturation region. Next, coming into the second unit, we discussed about basic circuit concepts and circuit design process. In the sense, circuit concepts means seat resistance and capacitance and wiring capacitance and different drawbacks of these capacitance. And coming into the second part, that is circuit design process. In this we can cover layout design rules, layout design for CMOS and stick diagrams for CMOS and as well as the BiCMOS. These are the covered to second. Coming into the third end, that is called gate level and physical design. So gate level means in order to design any IC, the basic building blocks are gates. Gate level design in terms of CMOS, in terms of NMOS, in terms of BiCMOS. Apart from this, also we can cover alternative forms of the CMOS logic. Alternative forms, we have 5 different types of alternative logic forms are available. So in order to reduce the transistor count compared to the CMOS logic, these alternative forms use effective designing of the CMOS and as well as NMOS. So now we can go for overview of fourth unit, subsystem design and VLSI design style. Subsystem design means in order to implementation of overall design with single format, that is very complex design. So that's where we are partitioning the main system design into sub parts. That subsystem we can call as subsystem design. So for example, we will consider the ALU design into different parts. Control unit, memory, these are the subsystem design. So now move into the fifth unit, VHDL synthesis and testing. Synthesis is nothing but converting the VHDL code into hardware components, that is called the synthesis. Synthesis output we can call as netlist. Netlist consists of a different logical blocks. So once completing the these all logical implementation, next go for the testing. This is the overview of fifth unit. Now we can continue from the second part of the third unit, that is called the physical design cycle. Physical design cycle means, so after completion of the everything designing, so now that is implemented in physical format, in the sense physical presentation. So due to that we have every designer, we can implement it different stages. That is called the main design divided into the sub parts, that is called the circuit partitioning. After completion of the partitioning, next go for floor planning and placement. Once completion of this step, next go for routing. After that, layout optimization. Next, attraction, extraction and verification. Verification in the sense to verify the our logic with delay and without delay. Once we can verify work, it means next go for the fabrication unit. So now we can go for simply about discuss about partitioning. Partitioning in the sense, so main design divided into the subparts in order to for easy designing purpose and easy implementation. So that designing partitioning each we can call as subsystem design. Once the completion of the partitioning, next go for floor planning. Floor planning is the process of identify the appropriate location of the IC within the IC. Once you can find out the appropriate location, next go for placement of particular item in the particular place, that is called the placement of design. Each and every placement and floor planning, the main aim is to reduce the size of design and increase the speed of operation. Once you can complete the floor planning and placements, next go for routing. Routing is nothing but the internal connections of the blocks in terms of VCC and supply voltage and all those things which we can. Now we can go for block diagram or physical design. So in detail of physical design, once recall the VLSI design flow. VLSI design flow, first step is system specification. System specifications in the terms of what number of pins, what is the delay, number of inputs, number of outputs, like that we can go for different specifications. Once completion of a system specification, next go for architectural design. Architectural means it is a imaginary block diagram of our design, that is called architectural design. Once you can go for programming part, we can design compulsory architectural design. So once completed of architectural, next go for functional design. Functional design means in that architecture we have different logical blocks. In this logical block we can implement different logic function and logic design, that is nothing but a function designing. Next go for circuit designing. So group of logic we can implemented circuits. That circuit design is nothing but a subsystem design. Once the circuit design, we can go for simulation. So after simulation we can go for synthesis. Simulation is nothing but a functionality verification of our design. So after simulation, next step is synthesis. After synthesis we can go for physical design. Physical design is divided into six different parts. First one, partitioning, floor planning, placement, clock distribution, signal distribution and time verification. So these are the different steps are included in physical design. So partitioning, why you can go for partitioning means in order to effective designing, large design is partitioning into subsystems. Once we can complete the partition, next go for floor planning. Floor planning, already I told, floor planning is the process of allocating the right place to the right pins or any logic within the total IC. Once completed floor planning, next go for placement. According to floor planning, placing the logical blocks in the respective identified places, that is nothing but a placement. The main target of floor planning and placement is to reduce the size. Once we can completing, next go for routing. So after routing we can complete everything, signals as well as timing. Next completing this, we can go for timing verification. Next we can go for the fabrication process.